Hello astronomers! If you are just beginning your journey into astrophotography with telescopes, welcome! In this video, we'll cover what really matters when you're starting, beyond just the gear. Have you ever looked at breathtaking photos of the moon, planets, or distant galaxies and wondered, how do people capture that? Well, astrophotography is not just a technical hobby. It's a way of connecting with the universe. So let's start with this. What makes astrophotography with telescopes so special? When you look through a telescope with your eyes, you can see amazing things. But our eyes aren't great at collecting light or seeing colors in faint objects. A camera changes everything. It allows you to go deeper, to collect more light over time, and to reveal stunning details invisible to the naked eye. That's where the magic begins. But before diving into the main types of astrophotography with telescopes, let's make an important distinction. When people think of night sky photography, they often refer to wide field images taken with a DSLR or mirrorless cameras on tripod or simple star trackers, capturing constellations, the Milky Way, or star trails at low magnification. This kind of photography is beautiful, accessible, and doesn't require a telescope or complex setup. But it's also limited to the low magnification and to the low exposure time allowed by the fact that you are not using any gear to correctly track the apparent motion of stars in the night sky. Astrophotography with telescopes, on the other hand, brings you closer, literally, to the moon, planets, star clusters, nebulae, up to the most distant galaxies. It requires more specialized equipment, such as a mount that tracks the sky and a telescope that gathers and focuses light. But the result reveals details that are simply invisible to the naked eye. This is the type of astrophotography we are talking about in this video. Now, astrophotography with telescopes can be divided into two main categories, planetary and deep sky. Planetary astrophotography is often the first type of astrophotography that beginners try, and for a good reason. It focuses on bright and detailed objects like the Moon, Jupiter, and Saturn. Since these targets are bright, you don't need very long exposures, and this means that you also don't need a very complex telescope setup to start in planetary astrophotography. A standard computerized mount is often enough, and of course you will need a telescope, usually with a long focal length to create high magnification. If your telescope has a shorter focal length, you can increase magnification by using a Bortle lens. The most common technique used in planetary astrophotography is called lucky imaging. You record a video made of hundreds or even thousands of frames, and then use specialized software to select and stack the sharpest ones. This helps you to overcome the blurring caused by atmospheric turbulence and extract the finest possible details from your data. Deep sky astrophotography is a whole different adventure. You'll be capturing faint objects, such as galaxies, nebulae, and star clusters. Here, the focus is not only on magnification, but especially on long exposure time and precise tracking to gather enough light from these distant sources. This kind of imaging is more demanding, often requires hours of exposure time, precise tracking and guiding systems, and cooled astronomical cameras to reduce noise. But the payoff is stunning. you'll be able to reveal the delicate structures in galaxies, or the vibrant color of nebulae, details that are otherwise invisible. A common question I often get about astrophotography with telescope is, can I do astrophotography from home? The short answer is yes, but your result will depend on the type of target and your sky conditions. In fact, if you're imaging planets or the moon, light pollution isn't a big problem. These objects are bright, and the main issue becomes atmospheric turbulence or seeing, that has to be as stable as possible for the best results. For deep sky objects, however, dark skies are very important. Light pollution from streetlights or buildings scatters in the atmosphere and reduces visibility of faint celestial details. To find the darker skies, you can check your location's Bortle Scale rating or use devices like the Eye of the Eagle computer or a sky quality meter. You can also use www.lightpollutionmap.info to explore dark sky locations near you. The darker the sky, the higher the contrast, making deep sky objects stand out more clearly against the background. As you can see, astrophotography with telescopes really is a journey. The first picture you take might be simple, but it's yours. It's a record of light that traveled for thousands or even millions of years to reach your telescope. And the beauty of this path is how much control and creativity you gain. Every step, from capturing to editing, is part of your own cosmic masterpiece. If you're ready to start, you are not alone. We at Prima Luce Lab are here to support you with tools, knowledge, and inspiration. So, if you want to know more, check out my book, Explore the Universe Through Astrophotography, Capturing Pictures with Telescopes and Play Software. You can read and download it for free from our website, www.primalucelab.com, or you can even order the printed hardcover version if you prefer. And as usual, for more content that will help you to explore the universe like a pro, subscribe to our channel and clear skies!